Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
What's great about living with Xolos is that they are super bonded to their person. There's almost a spiritual connection, and people that have Xolos will tell you, like everyone, it's kind of like the go-to saying that you don't understand how different they are until you have a Xolo. But what's so great about living with Xolos is that they are silly, they're funny dogs, and the bond is, in my opinion, something you can't really beat compared to other breeds. I've only been in Xolos for about 6 years. I don't have the most experience, but I'm currently being mentored by quite a few people. And I've been a dog trainer for about 23 years. So I'm a canine certified fitness trainer. It's a program through University of Tennessee. And basically what I do is I create fitness programs for canine athletes. How I discovered Xolos was when I was living in Washington State. I was helping and mentoring with a dog trainer out there. She had a Xoloitzcuintli client. It's a good friend of mine, and I met her dog and I was just really fascinated with them at that point. So it led to me researching and just thinking they were a cool dog. I'm half Mexican, and I was not raised with my Mexican heritage. Since Xolos have come into my life, I feel like it brought me in tune with that side of my culture that I didn't I wasn't raised with, and just has brought me to my spirituality as far as being a Hispanic American. I didn't really know much about Dia de los Muertos when I was growing up. I was not raised with any of that part of my culture. And the history of the breed kind of goes into how the Xoloitzcuintli was literally created by the god Xolot. So it's just something that kind of has helped me, and the significance of the breed in the Dia de los Muertos particular has been really influential to me and very eye-opening to how beautiful this culture really is. The Xoloitzcuintli they're assuming that they're closer to about 4,000 years old. They're a primitive ancient breed, so there's not too much known except for through ancient digs found in Colima and all of those regions of Mexico. I explain them as a village dog with a standard. So originally the Xoloitzcuintli was meant to be a companion dog. There's three sizes. So there's the standard, in Mexico they call them intermediate, and then the minis. In the AKC it's considered mini and then a toy. The standards were used as guard dogs. So they were dogs that would bark at people. You know, they would, you know, kind of sort of protect the home. I say that with parentheses because they're not really aggressive, but they will let you know anything that's different in the environment. The minis, they typically use them as hot water bottle, basically a hot water bottle. So they would curl up in bed with sick people. They believe that they had healing powers, and I do believe that's just because they were really warm. They're basically, the breed is intended to be a professional cuddler is what I call them. That's what I tell people. So living with Xolos is loud, for one. They do bark at quite a few things. I've had a lot of people tell me that their Xolos bark and they wonder about that, but they are vocal. They do let you know when things are amiss. They are entertaining. Basically, I tell, they're a little bit kind of like cats in the way that they interact. Because they like to be relaxing at home, cuddling on the bed, but they also have a lot of energy. So they can be very athletic. They typically play very well with each other. And when you get more than one Xolo together, it's pretty entertaining. So I would describe Xolos as, for one, aloof. They are not the dog that's going to go to a party and be friends with everybody like, say, a golden retriever would. They can be very standoffish. However, the smaller sizes, in my experience, have been a lot friendlier. They're more open to going and saying hello to people. They are playful, high energy. I would say high energy. The AKC breed standard describes them as calm. I feel like that doesn't happen until they're about 2 to 3 years old. They're crazy little puppies. They're very, very wild. They're kind of all over the place. But they are athletic. They like to do something, and they're extremely intelligent. Xolos can have same-sex aggression. Some lines are known for that. There is not necessarily, I wouldn't call it aggression with other animals, but they can have a very high prey drive. So if you have animals like reptiles, it can be an issue. Sochi, when she was a puppy, used to kill snakes. So we had to remedy that because we live in California and there's rattlesnakes out here. Socialization is the most important thing for Xolos. A lot of people miss out on that. What we don't realize is dogs do have a finite socialization period. So you have from birth up until about 6 to 7, or they say about 8 to 9 months old to really socialize them. I feel like it's more like 6 to 7 months is the most critical period of socialization. They need to be exposed to everything. Basically, when you get a Xolo as a puppy, they're almost like feral, and you have to kind of domesticate them into being okay with everything. They're very standoffish and very suspicious of things that they don't recognize. Training Xolos is a different kind of challenge. They're really smart, but they are not biddable, which means they're not a kind of dog that really wants to do what you want them to do. They want to do what they want to do. So it's very much convincing them why they should do something. Fortunately, most Xolos are crazy food motivated and will do, they almost to the point that the food is distracting for them. So Xolos can be good with kids if they're raised with them. They don't have a good reputation with kids, but I do feel like a lot of people don't properly socialize them to kids. I personally have a 10-year-old that when she was 7, we got Sochi. I knew going into it that they don't have a great reputation with kids, so I did a lot of work proactively to work on that. I had her do a lot of the basic foundations. She's not great with toddlers because I didn't get the chance to really expose her to a lot of toddlers, so we manage at that point. I think that Xolos can be a good breed for older people if they're able to give them the physical stimulation that they need, the physical exercise that they need, and the mental stimulation. They're not necessarily a couch potato, but they are content to kind of hang out. I wouldn't consider them for somebody who really can't keep up with them, though. Exercise with Xolos is very important. I do feel like generally I get my dogs about an hour a day. Mental stimulation, though, is more important than physical stimulation in a lot of senses of the word. So as long as you are working their mind, you are exercising the dog, but they do need to run. I feel like they should have a minimum of a 30-minute walk a day, but an hour is ideal. Xolos don't have a lot of teeth, and that's a result of the FOX 13 genetic mutation that causes them to be hairless. So it's kind of a direct correlation, but it doesn't cause them any problems. The teeth that they do have are very healthy. It doesn't cause them any problems with things like chewing bones. For instance, my Sochi, I've given her whole prey, which is, you know, literally like a sheep's head. And she has had no problem taking care of that in a very, very speedy fashion. So I wouldn't say they have dietary restrictions. They can be prone to allergies, just like any dog, though. It's dependent. So my dog is Sochi, and I didn't realize this going into the breed, but Sochi is basically the Bella or Max of the dog breed names. There's so many Sochi, Xoloitzcuintlis out there, but I got her, she was actually rehomed to me. So someone kind of bit off more than they could chew, and unfortunately her breeder didn't do what they were supposed to do and take her back. So she just kind of came to me. They, like I said, they wanted her to be a service dog, but they had no experience on how to train a service dog. And historically, the breed is not a breed I would recommend as a service dog for someone who's not experienced. My personal plans with Xolos is I am an aspiring breeder. I've wanted to breed dogs since I was 10 years old. I was raised with breeders. So that's kind of been my life goal in general. I've always wanted to do that. It just took me, I always say it took me 30 years to find my heart breed. So now I know that I would like to proceed forward with Xolos, in a more of a performance aspect. They're not really known for having working or performance lines because the breed wasn't developed for anything in particular, but they are really good at things like any dog sport, agility, obedience. They can be awesome with it. Xoloitzcuintli Club of America is the first thing that I recommend to people to check out. It has some good information on their website as well as a good breeder directory. The other resource that I have, which is the shirt that I'm wearing is Xolo Supply Company. We do a lot of education. We go and speak. We actually have an event coming up in March. My name is Mallory, and once again, I am a CCFT. I have an Instagram account, Canine Fit Bitch, as well as TikTok. I also have a website, caninefitbitch.com. If you have any questions about Xolos, you're more than welcome to reach out to me. I'm always happy to educate and help out with this breed, work with them as well. So.